Hey everybody, this is Nathan Lehman. I'm at the Ultra Running Company in Charlotte, North Carolina, and I am here to do a shoe review on what quite honestly is the most pleasant surprise of my day so far, and that is the Hoka One One Clifton 8. In Ultra Running Company parlance, this is a comfort cushioned, low drop road running shoe. We talk about the drop of this shoe, and what that means is we're looking at the heel to toe offset, so the amount of cushion here under the heel versus the amount of cushion here under the toe. And this is advertised as a 5 millimeter offset on the shoe, so slightly higher in the heel than it is in the forefoot. When we measured this shoe, we got 26.2 millimeters in the heel and 32.6 millimeters in the front. And then something odd happened. We generally speaking, when we look at the insoles in these shoes, we measure all of our shoes with this insole out. And that gives us some consistency there. With this shoe, it's one of the rare shoes where the insole was actually half a millimeter thicker on the heel. And we measured it a number of times to make sure. But what that means is that when we combine the insole, which is slightly thicker in the heel, with the measurements we got in the heel and the toe, we got about 30 millimeters in the forefoot and 36 millimeters in the heel, so slightly more than Hoka advertises. What that means is this really brushes up on the edge of what we call a high drop shoe. Now at the Ultra Running Company, we don't carry any shoes with more than 8 millimeters of cushion, so kind of that 6 to 8 millimeters is our high end. There are certainly shoes that have bigger heels, but what we find is when you have those shoes, you come through your gait cycle and the heel has more of an opportunity to hit in front of your body. Folks with really efficient form that are always landing on their fore to midfoot, they're not gonna have a huge issue with anything over 8 millimeters. But as we talk to our customers and say, hey, we'd really like you to land under your center of gravity with a bent knee, we find that those higher drop shoes make it a little bit tougher to land efficiently. So what's happened is the Clifton, although advertised, it's still right in that low drop area with 5 millimeters. By adding that extra millimeter almost entirely in the heel, it's just on the edge of a higher drop shoe for us. We did not notice it at all when running. We were still able to land in the same way. We were still able to toe off and push off later on, and the heel didn't get in our way, but it is noticeable. You kind of have to have calibrated feet to feel that difference, so we didn't see it until we really got it under our calibration tools. But what we just thought it was worth pointing out, because there's some significant differences on this shoe, and that's just a preview. So let's talk about this. The interesting thing, and I brought along a prop, and I don't usually do this, but I brought along a prop of the old Clifton 7. And what you'll find is that these two shoes look really, really similar. I'm almost indistinguishable from each other. But the difference underneath is what really surprised us with this version, the Clifton 8. So I'll go through those details really quickly here, and then we'll hit them as we go. First of all, they've completely changed the foam from the Clifton 7 to the Clifton 8. Looks the same, performs completely differently. They've kind of streamlined some of their items. So in the past, where we had these stitches here and kind of a hard built up upper, we've got more of a bonded upper on the Clifton 7. So what does that do? Well, my suspicion is that the cushion in this shoe might be just slightly heavier than the cushion in the Clifton 7. And that's made up for with some efficiencies on this upper area. So even though it looks the same, we really think once you dig in, you're gonna be really pleasantly surprised with this Clifton 8. Let's jump on this as we normally do. First of all, starting from the bottom, what you do have is a completely different tread pattern. Again, going back to the Clifton 7, what you'll see is that they've actually bonded a couple of these blocks. They've changed the tread pattern from a kind of a U shape here, a chevron, into a diagonal across, and they've bonded these together. So they've actually, again, added a little bit of cushion, a little bit of tread on these on the shoe. This is the high wearing, high abrasion part, and so they've added a little bit right through here in this area right here, and it just it makes it the sole probably weigh a little bit more, but also gives you a longer life. So as you build up, you get to this second layer. The Clifton has always been what we call compressed EVA rubber. And what that means is that they make this big piece of rubber, they cut it the way they want it, and then they just slam it down and put it into the shape of, in a mold, into the shape of this shoe. And while this looks the same, they've really upgraded the rubber. And we were kind of shocked when we put it on our feet. The Clifton's always been a very cushy, pillowy shoe. This is now a very, very compliant shoe. And by that, I mean, there was some rigidity in the old Clifton from when you first put it on and kind of a squared off feel. This shoe kind of moves with your foot. If you pronate, awesome, it pronates with you. If you supinate a little bit, it's gonna supinate with you. But because of that bucket that all the Hokas have, kind of this geometry where you sit inside the shoe, you really always go back to center in a Hoka. And that's really their kind of killer app that they introduced when they came out with the product. And so you've got all this new rubber. We were very happy to see that it retained that really pillowy, cushiony feel, but it just feels a little bit more springy, like it has a little more pop. We first experienced this in the new Mach 4, and we've got to believe that some of the rubber from that Mach 4 is now coming over into the Clifton. So good news there. There's also just a lot of cushion here, and when you go up to 37 millimeters of cushion, you're talking a serious shoe. The Bondi 7 that we had lying around, that's only 39 millimeters of cushion, and that is probably one of the most plush shoes on the market. So what you're getting is a baby Bondi, as always, but something that's got about 2 ounces less weight and a similar amount of cushion now. So this really makes this, takes it from a racing training shoe into a racing training slow day long run type of shoe that we used to reserve for that Bondi. As we go up, we go to this upper. I talked a little bit about it before. Again, I'm going to show you this Clifton 7. They look very similar next to each other, you know, just some changes in the design. But what we found is, while this came off as a little bit stiff putting it on our foot, we had to tie it onto our foot, the Clifton 8 almost hugs around our foot. It just seems like this upper material, this engineered mesh, is a little more taut here around your instep while still giving you a decent amount of flexibility and room on the toe. So we really like that. We like your toes to be able to move around in shoes. Again, really no overlays at all on this shoe. There's the mesh does the job by being thicker in some places and lighter in others. It's got some breathable areas here. One thing that we really like, and more and more brands are doing this now, is when you go into the shoe itself, it's got what's called a gusset, and that really holds your tongue in place. So as you go up the shoe, you're gonna see that the Clifton 8 still has a little lock here for your tongue to make sure that it doesn't slide from one side to the other. But really, that's a little bit cosmetic because this gusset is holding it in place. It makes it impossible to go from one side to another. While we're on this tongue, it seems to be about the same material as on the Clifton 7. There's some stitching in it that almost makes it seem like it, again, hugs your foot just a little bit better than before. It's still a very plush tongue, so if you like your thin tongues that they really kind of end up on your ankle, this is going to be more plush, a little more pillowy. Again, going with the overall approach of this shoe, very cushy, very lightweight. Move to the back. We've got what Hoka has incorporated in lately, this kind of elf fin on the back. We've kind of gotten used to putting our foot in it. It doesn't make it, they talk about being able to pull it up. Basically what it means is when you go to put on your shoe, you're just gonna be able to pop your foot right in here. There are some carvings on the inside of the shoe that hold it in, so you're not gonna feel this against your Achilles. Definitely know some customers that'll have an issue when a shoe comes in, it hits their Achilles in a different place. You're not gonna have a problem like that with the Hoka Clifton and Clifton 8. So what does this weigh? All this cushion, a little bit lighter weight upper. What it does is it comes in at a women's 7.6 ounces and men's 8.8 ounces. And I wanted to point out that one of the differences there is that recently Hoka has started adjusting the amount of cushion. So generally speaking, you can take off 3 millimeters from the measurements that I gave you for the female shoe. This makes it a little bit lighter. Generally, the women are a little bit smaller than the men. And so in women's sizes, they're putting a little bit less cushion, getting the same effect. We think that overall the feel is pretty spot on across the genders. So Men's 8.8 ounces. When I measured that in what I consider a human size foot, a size 13, that came in at 11.1 ounces, which is almost exactly the same as the Clifton 7. So as I said, they've added a little high durability rubber on the bottom, added I think a little bit of weight in this cushion, taken a bit off on the upper, and what you come up with is a shoe that's within 0.1 ounces of the old Clifton 7. Now, I've measured it a couple times. Some come in around 11.2 ounces, some come in at 11.1. So overall, just a really nice, surprisingly nice package for the Clifton 8. We're really happy to be able to get out and do some more miles on it. We suspect, while we haven't worn out a pair of Cliftons yet, we suspect that this rubber is actually a longer lasting rubber. So we expect that if you look at kind of the generalized industry averages, under 250 would be a fast wearing shoe, 250 to 350/400 would be an average shoe. Over 400 would be a very long lasting shoe. We think this is gonna touch on the high end of that 250 to 400, and we're really excited about that. That's a place that the Clifton has not been in the past, both due to wearing off in early versions for sure on the bottom, and more recently, just a little compression in the material that they were using before. So we think this is becoming a longer life, a longer run type shoe, almost buffering up against where that Bondi was. What does it cost? It's $130, no change in the price of this shoe, so you're saving about $20 over the Bondi. Overall, they're different feeling shoes. There's going to be a little bit less squared off kind of stable feature on the Clifton, just because it is a little softer and a little lighter, whereas the Bondi is going to be a little bit wider, a little bit more squared off. Great for walking, great for long runs. This really is kind of encroaching now on that long run territory that the Bondi has kind of owned for the last number of years. So we hope you liked the interview. We really suggest you give this shoe a try. Clifton's been a favorite of a lot of people for a long time. It's had different iterations where we've absolutely adored it and kind of pushed back on them as well in other iterations. We think this is one of the better that we've seen in quite some time. We think it's gonna be a lot more fun to run in. I think you'll enjoy your runs when you go out, and we think you're gonna get a lot of life out of it. So if you have any questions, please put them in our comments section. Let us know what we're doing well, what we're not doing well. Please subscribe to the channel, and we're excited to be here, and we're excited for you to learn to love to run. Thanks, and have a great day.